man, I wonder why Coach is late. It's his own fault if I finish all this off before he gets here, because we are at Emma L's Italian Kitchen for this week's edition of the Lee Blankenship Coaches Show. Welcome in, Bronco Nation, to week 8 of the Lee Blankenship Coaches Show. I'm voice of the Broncos, Ryan Booth, and joined once again the head coach of the Mustang Broncos, Lee Blankenship. Coach, how are you tonight?
Man, doing great. Season is moving right along. It's hard to, but we say it every week.
I know, every week. Week 8. And hey, you know, I won't say complained about it, but I've mentioned a few times to our outstanding assistant athletic director, Greg Oliver. Greg, when do we get to go to a restaurant? Okay, and look, he came through.
He came through big time tonight.
Yeah, we are here at Emma L's Italian Kitchen, 4401 Grant Boulevard, Suite 3, right here on Route 66 and the Kilpatrick Turnpike, kind of out here over in the Lake Overholser area. So, beautiful place and
super cool atmosphere here.
Yeah, Coach, I promise I'm not ignoring you, but they just right before we went on, they brought out the appetizer with, it looks like some wood fired bread with the old olive oil and things like that. So first commercial break, we may have to get into that.
See
just
a piece
a little
or two
bit.
Missing. Yeah,
might be gone. Hey, if Tobler was here, the whole thing would be gone already.
Most likely. So that's most likely true.
We wouldn't have had any of that. But again, we want to give a big thank you to everyone here at Emma L's Italian Kitchen. So actually, we'll have an opportunity to talk to owner Cameron Wilson a little bit later on in the show. No offense, but what I'm really looking forward to is, getting into some of that food. So the show might be about 5 minutes because that wood fire pizza oven behind us is fired up and going as well. But thanks for joining us here for this episode. We'll take a short time out and be back with more on this week's edition of the Lee Blankenship Coaches Show.
Discover authentic Italian cuisine at Emma L's in West OKC, featuring freshly prepared Italian favorites. Everything made to order. Dine in or get it to go. Emma L's Italian Kitchen, Kilpatrick Turnpike and 39th Expressway. Let us do the cooking.
Our mission here at Oral Surgery Specialists of Oklahoma is to provide exceptional care to our patients in a warm and welcoming environment.
We enjoy creating an exceptional experience for our patients with belief in patient education, careful listening, and customized treatment planning.
Here at Oral Surgery Specialists of Oklahoma, we uniquely offer a full scope of oral surgery and periodontal services under one roof, including dental implant placement, wisdom teeth removal, gum grafting, and jaw surgery.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to this week's edition of the Lee Blankenship Coaches Show, again here at Emma L's. And Coach, We left it intact.
We did.
The willpower came through again, all the way back to the beginning of the season. We talked about you've been living on chicken and broccoli.
I've tried to get in shape. A place like this could absolutely destroy the diet.
It'll wreck it.
Yeah, which is probably going to happen regardless. To be honest,
it's going to be. But no, hey, 4-3 now on the season. 1-3 in district play. A tough one up at Tulsa Union, and I mean, you can't always just. You'll never blame it on one thing, but, man, you would have liked to have seen how that game would have gone if Trajan had been able to stay in the whole game, because the opening drive was incredible.
Defense got a stop right off the bat, had a great opening drive, went 80 yards and scored the touchdown there. Trajan had a great drive going. He was really instrumental, in the drive. He really carried it down the field.
Two fourth down conversions on that drive, and one of them, 4th and 1, get it. The other one, maybe you're in Aiden Jordan field goal range, but did you guys feel that it was really important to put 7 on the board?
Absolutely. We wanted to go down, and honestly just felt a lot of confidence, in our kids and the way we had them kind of, on their heels a little bit and scrambling.
For sure.
Trying to figure out a way to stop our interior run game. So, was proud of our guys. They battled. Obviously, Trajan went down with the injury, and that put us in a tough situation and faced a little bit of adversity there and didn't come away with, the win. Everything kind of fell off after the injury. But I'm with you. I would have loved to have seen, what would have happened if Trajan hadn't have gotten hurt.
Well, and that first drive, still kind of sticking with that for a second, is you guys played with a lot of tempo. And you said, yeah, great play calling, great scheme, because you were really hitting the inside run. And then just when you'd think that's what was going to come again, Coach McDaniel, little just outside pass, just kind of an extension of the run game.
Absolutely.
Nothing deep down the field, but just to keep them, like you said, on their heels.
Yeah, absolutely. It's good opening script by Coach McDaniel. Offensive staff did a good job. What stunk was when Trajan went down, our game plan, you know, about three quarters of it went down with him. And, you know, I'd say this, the freshman Tyson Pogai came in and just fearless.
Didn't flinch.
We didn't have him in great situations. You talk about it, just an almost impossible situation to come into.
Yeah.
But we're excited. Tyson's gonna play this week, and man, I've watched him since he was probably in about the sixth grade, and been excited about getting him up to our level, and he's here, and he's excited to play as well. I expect him to have a good week.
Yeah, he came right out, got after it, and I mean, you said it, did not flinch. I mean, ran out there like he expected to be on the field.
Threw some great balls. We had a couple of drops early. Yes. There was one deflected that was intercepted. When something like that happens and then, you know, the opponent just, you know, sees the situation, there's a little bit of blood in the water, and they pinned their ears back and came after him. But I was really proud of just, you know, his ability to come in. You talk about a ninth grader coming in at Tulsa Union, you know, and just playing with a bunch of confidence. Yeah. I was very proud of that.
Very, very poised young man. And he's not, I mean, he's used to pressure. I mean, he's been, you know, he's outstanding basketball player, outstanding football player, has played both sports, multiple sports for a long time. So this isn't the first time he's probably come into a tough situation.
He was born into it.
I mean, born ready.
He's a coach's kid.
Yeah.
And he's just a competitor. And again, you know, a lot of guys in the situation that he was in and the situation that he's in this week, you know, a little bit of panic sets in. You can see it in the eyes. Tyson's just a competitor. I'm really excited to watch him go have an opportunity to actually lead and compete. Yeah. So should be good.
Again, I mean, third week in a row, the guys did not quit. Played their tails off the entire game. And you know, maybe in the past you would have seen some teams, maybe not here in Mustang, but in some other places, but you know, the same script 3 weeks in a row. It's easy to begin to kind of maybe doubt yourself. But
absolutely,
these guys don't.
Well, our kids are resilient. But listen, we got to remember this too. We started the year off 4-0.
Yeah. We're still 4-3.
Then we got to play. We got to play the gauntlet in this schedule.
I think they called
UConn.
It Red October.
That's exactly right. We played UConn, which is our rival,
yep,
and got a win there. Then Owosso, Edmond Santa Fe, which is one of the best teams in Oklahoma this year, and everybody knows it, beat Jinx in their first game, beat us by a touchdown, and then Tulsa Union. So, I mean, that's a really, really tough schedule. Yeah. For our kids, our kids aren't going to flinch. We understand that we're a good football team, and our heads are up. Our kids battled the entire time. We're not going to quit. You know, and it's just the ball did not bounce our way a few times in this three-game stretch. But we're eyes forward, and we've got three more to play right now.
Well, and you only get so many opportunities, and I know you talk about that with the guys. Guys, we've got three more opportunities in the regular season. We can't dwell on what's in the past. And we've talked about it a number of times, Coach. It goes back to that culture that you guys talk about. Control what you can control. You've got to have a short memory at times. There's nothing you can do about that now. You can't dwell on it, or it's going to affect what happens this week.
Well, again, our kids are just resilient. They're bought into our culture.
Yep.
Our standard is our best. And what that means is we want to be our very best in every category.
Yep.
Every area. When we're on the football field on Friday night, sometimes I can be my best. I can be, you know, in a reserve role and get put in the game. And I am absolutely playing my very best. And the guy across from me is just a little bit better. Yep. That doesn't mean that I'm a failure. You're successful when you maximize what God gave you and your potential.
Yep.
And our kids do that. And again, I think I said it last week. I can't. George Washington, General George Washington said that. I can't promise we're always going to going to win, but I can promise that when we do win, we'll deserve it.
Deserve it, and our kids deserve
to win. And the ball's going to get back on our side. I promise.
But again, another tough one. But we're back at home this week. We'll have an opportunity to talk about that one here coming up in just a little bit. But kind of picked out some plays again this week. It's a tough game, but there's still some things that you can pull from that film, from that highlight reel, to just show what these guys are capable of, how talented they are, and again, how they continue to fight down the stretch when things aren't really going their way. The first one is the first fourth down conversion on that opening drive. Again, it keeps the drive alive. It's fourth and one. Trajan, I believe we're on our 35, and Trajan goes for a 15-yard run out to midfield. We're at the 50. We get it down to their 35. That's a gutsy call at midfield that early in the game.
When you're playing teams that are, national powerhouses, you have to be aggressive and you have to hit some on them. And that's always going to be our game plan. And if you don't hit them, then you give them one of the best offenses in the country, the ball on the 50. But if you do hit it, then you keep it out of their hands and you go down and have a chance to go and score. So that's, it's always aggressive when really that's pretty much our philosophy anyways, but especially when you're playing teams that let's be honest, are a little bit more talented than you.
Yeah. So, and you've said it. I mean, you're going to be aggressive.
Yeah.
And sometimes it's going to get away from you. High risk, high reward.
Sure.
And then, but you
same
guys.
Same exact thing. When we played Ebb in Santa Fe, we're down three touchdowns. We're aggressive. Yeah. And we put ourselves back in the game. If we hadn't hit a couple of those, we could have extended the deficit that we were down.
You've just got to go take it. You've got to make a decision that I'm going to go
take
it.
That's football. We want to attack. We want to attack it with everything we have. And, again, we're going to throw everything we've got every week at every opponent and do what we can to win the game.
Second one on the same drive. And, again, I'm sure the first time this gives you a little more confidence. It gives the guys a little more confidence. Fourth and three, another fourth down conversion to keep that opening drive alive. Again, another fourth down conversion. Yep. Again, just to move the chains and give you guys another chance. But again,
a lot of that's just our pace as well. We're playing really fast. At that point, the decision had already been made.
We're going.
If it's inside that 3 yard, window, we're going. So we already had the call on and picked that one up as well.
And then number three, obviously, is the touchdown run to finish it off, finish that drive off. You cash in on it. But again, the thing that sticks out to me is, Trajan with his size, and we talk about the Trajan horse, how sometimes he just bulls his way through, but also his patience and his vision to find a hole. Maybe the original gap's not there, but just how patient he is with the ball in his hands.
Trajan just got better and better and more comfortable every week this season. And listen, a lot of coaches, and I'm probably in that category, don't like to talk about injuries, but I do. I want to share with our fans exactly what happened because it's more than anything, it's just a testament to
him.
Trajan. So Trajan actually broke his hand on the first fourth down conversion, and played the entire drive. He said it felt numb. He came over to the sideline, told us his hand was hurt, and he's been banged up all year. I mean, when you run the ball 40 times and you're quarterbacks, he took a lot of hits and a lot of hits on his body. But he's still trying to throw the football, telling us he's not sure if he can. But he actually went back in and played another two possessions in the game, or at least in spots. And then we would put Tyson in there, when it was a obvious passing situation, which is not fair to Tyson, and tough for him as well. They're yelling pass when Tyson's going in the game.
Yeah, he's running off the sideline,
which is actually a compliment to Tyson because those guys have seen if you have the scouting report on Tyson, that he's very accurate and he can throw the ball really well, and that's definitely a strength. But Trajan, literally, I think he probably carried the ball four or five more times with a broken hand after he broke it.
If it happened on that first that first one, that was at 9:52. He gets into the end zone at about 6.5 minutes. So he plays, another 4 minutes or so with that hand not 100%.
Yeah, obviously. He might have carried it six or seven more times in, and if that's the fact, but. Just a tough kid, man, and loves his teammates and sacrificed his body. Yeah. And we love him. We are heartbroken for him. You know, obviously, you know, going out any time in the season, but, you know, going out in that game like that is really tough. But one of the things Coach McDaniel says, and Trajan would be the first guy sitting here screaming it, and was the first guy at the tent when Tyson went in, is he says, how deep? And our kids say, too deep. Yeah. And what that means is it's a next man up mentality. When I get my opportunity, I need to be prepared, and I'm going to be ready because we have a lot of depth in our program. And that's what we want to build and create that mindset in the guys that are twos and threes even. And it's time for Tyson to get to go out and show that.
Another thing that I liked watching that night was the aggressive nature that the defense played with. Again, they run a lot of read option and things like that. Talented quarterback, really good, couple really good running backs. And then, but at about 6:03, I think this was one of their first real RPO or read option opportunities. Caden Backus, he's got to read that perfect.
Yeah.
Because, and he flies in and gets the running back from behind. But if he's not disciplined like you teach our guys to be, that's a big play going the other way.
Absolutely. And just like you said, excellent read. And then Caden, when Caden gets a hold of you, you're going to the ground. He is a tough kid now. He's a wild man back there. And, you know, we're talking about a sophomore. To have two sophomore linebackers starting in 6A. Yeah.
Josiah Stevens on the other side and then Caden.
Correct. Caden Backus on the other, and then you got Bear in between the two, which helps a lot. Excellent leadership, and has really, really helped bring those guys along and teach them how to prepare and be, you know, mature and professional about how they approach, you know, the game plan and practice every day. But those two guys as sophomores, you want to talk about just nerves of steel, the courage it takes to come in and play, especially in that position group. So we're really excited about both of those guys for sure, and got a couple more that are going to be really good also.
And then the last one I've got just shows second quarter, things are still – it's not as bad, you know, as it could have been, but things are kind of starting to get away. But it's 3rd and 14, and Union sets up a screen pass. And, again, Russell – the first time I saw it, I thought it was Bear – that broke up the pass, but it's actually big Russell Zollicoffer gets a hand up, knocks it down. Bears right there to get it, you know, make the tackle if it goes anywhere. But again, just the discipline on that play shows what Coach Gaines has done with this defense.
Yeah. Again, kids just play hard. They love their coach. Coach Gaines does a great job, has them in good situations. Yeah. You know, our defense, the amount of turnovers that we had, and again, that's nobody's fault. But when we turn the ball over and give the defense or our opponents a short field, it's a tough situation for the defense. There in that half at the halftime, we felt like we were in the game.
Yeah.
And it was definitely a situation where we felt like we were firmly still in it. They came out in the third quarter and returned the opening kickoff, and that didn't help much. Yeah. Eligibility has crushed us. You know, we've lost a couple of guys. We've lost a couple of guys to injuries. A couple of guys not out there on that unit because of eligibility, and that's something that has hurt our team. Our special teams have been excellent early in the year, and as of late, we can't keep giving up kickoff returns for touchdowns and expect to be very successful.
Yeah. But again, hey. Effort is always going to be there. These guys are never going to quit. There is still so much to play for. The ultimate goal is definitely still obtainable.
Sure.
And we know that these guys, there is no quit in any young man that is on that sideline wearing the Mustang helmet on Friday night.
We take a lot of pride in that logo and in our community and town, and our kids are going to represent us, our town, the right way, our school district the right way. They're going to play the entire time with all their hearts and leave everything out there, and you can bet the farm on that.
Yeah, definitely. So we see it week in and week out. I get a bird's eye view of it all the time, and there's not a group of guys or program that would make anybody prouder than these guys do. That is for sure. But tonight, hey, we are here once again at Emma L's Italian Kitchen, 4401 Grant Boulevard, right here on Route 66. Get your kicks
There you go.
And your Italian
and
food.
And your breadsticks.
And your get your kicks and your breadsticks here on Route 66 right off the Kilpatrick Turnpike. And we're actually going to take a few minutes. You and I both get to sit down with owner Cameron Wilson and talk about his outstanding establishment. So it's about dinner time, 6:30. Business is definitely picking up. So looking forward to talking to Cameron about Emma L's and some of this incredible food that we have got going on around us. So we will be back after this timeout and just do that. Again, you're watching the Lee Blankenship Coaches Show.
Discover authentic Italian cuisine at Emma L's in West OKC, featuring freshly prepared Italian favorites, everything made to order. Dine in or get it to go. Emma L's Italian Kitchen, Kilpatrick Turnpike and 39th Expressway. Let us do the cooking.
Here at Joe Cooper Ford, we have a wide selection of Ford trucks and SUVs to choose from. Plus, we'll give you more for your trade-in just to get you in that new Ford truck. And remember, we'll beat any competitor's price on a new Ford by $500, or we'll give you $10,000. Who loves Oklahoma?
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. We are here at Emma L's Italian Kitchen, and we are joined now by Cameron Wilson, the owner here of Emma L's. Cameron, thanks for being a great host tonight, and thanks for joining us.
Oh, absolutely. It's great to have you all with us. It's a pleasure to have you.
Hey, no offense, but, I mean, we want to talk to you about the restaurant, and we want to find out everything about ML's, but you've made a mistake.
Uh-oh.
By just putting this right here in front of us.
I'm paralyzed right now. My mouth is just watering. I can't stop staring at this.
I feel like I need a nap because I'm going to have to keep, if I drool while we're talking, hey, no offense, it's this right here.
This wonderful.
This looks absolutely incredible.
Well, thank you. We're very passionate about Italian food at Emma L's, and so hopefully this is a good representation of that passion coming through.
I don't think it's going to get any better.
Yeah,
great.
Maybe some tiramisu.
Okay.
Is that an option here?
We'll have to look into that.
Okay.
All right. We'll have to look into that.
Hey, beautiful restaurant.
Thank
you. Great, convenient location. How long have you guys been here?
We opened in August of 2022, so we're just over a year and a few months old, and we're having a great time meeting everybody in the community and having great Italian food, and it's been great just to meet everybody in the community.
Yeah, and it is. I mean, we're here on Route 66, so just west of Bethany, right off the Kilpatrick Turnpike. You can come from the north, the south, the east, the west, get right here, easy on and off. I mean, outstanding location in an area that you look around is really starting to grow commercially.
You're right. And when I first saw the location, I thought, man, this would be a great place for a sit-down lunch place for business meals, quick lunch, or that date night, family night dinner spot. And who doesn't love pizza and pasta was the other kind of thought.
Oh, yeah.
Thought in that thought process. Yeah.
And it's a really great atmosphere as well. You know, it's a cool setting. Very busy tonight, but feels like, you know, an Italian, old-school type of restaurant.
Yeah.
Great date night place.
Exactly.
Bring my wife here.
Exactly.
Hey, we've got this in front of us, and when we started the show tonight, and now it's gone. I mean, we devoured it when we had a commercial break, but your bread, the appetizer bread, best. I have eaten a lot of meals in my life, but that right there, and then the olive oil and everything that comes with it, incredible.
Well, I'm glad you think so. So we make that bread in-house, and it's four ingredients. We use flour, salt, yeast, and water to make that dough every day.
Sounds healthy.
It is. It is because it's limited ingredients, and so you know everything that goes into it. And then the olive oil and the balsamic, I have a firm belief that a good balsamic can make a difference in your day. And so I wanted to make sure we had a great balsamic to pair with that bread.
Big balsamic guy over here.
Good.
I love the balsamic.
Well, because – and it's got to be – I'm going to talk about things that maybe I don't really know about, but it's got to be the right ratio. It's got to be, because you get too little, you don't get enough of it, too much, it overpowers everything. So it was spot on. Now, your bread, do you guys bake that in the incredible pizza oven
that we see
rolling behind us right here?
So we have an Italian pizza oven that's made in Italy. It will get up to 900 degrees and can cook a pizza in 90 seconds. So you've really got to stay with it as you're cooking the bread items in that oven.
I don't even know.
That's
900
awesome.
Degrees.
That's awesome.
Man, I don't even imagine 900 degrees. I mean, and those guys right there, they're just going after it. I mean, we've seen them behind his time. I mean, they're just in and out, popping things in and out, 900 degrees. How often do you cook something at actually 900 degrees?
Oh, that's constant.
Oh, that's...
Yeah, it's constantly at 900.
All right.
Yeah.
Coach, we learn something everywhere we go.
It's pretty cool.
So,
I love learning about food. I'm a big caprese guy.
Okay.
So I know, and I judge an Italian food restaurant based on whether they have that on the menu, and I'm pretty excited about this
Coach,
place. This is my first experience here.
Coach,
I love a good caprese salad.
Throwing it out there.
Yeah.
Like caprese salad.
And those are salads are one of our top sellers. They're very popular here. So.
Pretty excited about it.
Wonderful.
Cultured man of the world as well, ladies and gentlemen.
Very cultured. Very cultured. So. Don't let the missing finger fool you. I'm very man of many cultures. So. And I also love caprese salad.
Okay. Emma Els, where does the name come from?
It's a tribute to the friend or friends that we all have who know their way around a kitchen. And anytime you go over to their place, it's just a given that it's wonderful food. And then what often follows wonderful food are friends and family and community. So the big idea is that great food and community come together at Emma L's Italian Kitchen.
Yeah. That needs to be marketed somewhere.
Okay,
I'm sure you probably got it on your website. So emmaels.com.
Yes, emmaels.com is the website. And I think we all have people like that in our lives. And I think that was kind of a cool connecting idea behind the name.
Cool. So. Now, we see some of the options right here. Coach has brought up the caprese salad. Extensive menu. You can probably only get a glimpse of part of it as the incredible pepperoni pizza here is covering up. But outside of what we see here, pepperoni pizza, this is one serving.
Right.
Of
this is our mama's lasagna.
This isn't family style.
Right. That's one serving. And we do have to-go boxes. So sometimes the lasagna, you know, it will travel well and eat well the next day. So that's a full portion of our lasagna.
Obviously, these are some of the more popular items on the menu. But
talk
to us for just a moment. This is not just a regular spaghetti and meatballs. There's something pretty unique about these meatballs.
Right. So we make our meatballs in-house, and we use a beef farm near Arcadia to source our beef from. And it is a Wagyu beef meatball.
That's
so
how you say it. Wagyu.
Yes, sir. Yeah.
And that's a breed.
That's a breed of cattle.
And but they're also tended to a very specific way.
Right. Okay. Taken care of. And they pay close attention to the diet that they feed those cattle and really make sure that they're healthy animals before they're harvested and turned into meatballs for us.
Before they're hey, sorry guys, you're going to be meatballs.
Yeah.
Not a bad deal for us, right? Kind of turns out well for us.
I'm for it. I'm in.
Yeah, I'm stoked. Let's get after it. Hey, Coach brought it up earlier. Great atmosphere for a date night, but also you look around and it's a good balance. We do see a number of couples in here tonight, but also a very family-friendly restaurant. So maybe you've got a picky eater. You've got some young kids that aren't quite as adventurous, don't want to go after the lasagna. What kind of things do you have to cater to that?
Sure. So we have a number of items on our kids' menu, and we have fried chicken tenders that we hand batter and fry on order, which is pretty universal. Most kids, I feel like, will eat either grilled or fried chicken tender, and then we serve those with fries. Then we also have kid-sized pizzas, or we could do a kid's Alfredo or a butter pasta, which just... You know, sometimes you get in too deep into the Italian fare and kids are like, I'm out of that. So we tried to kind of simplify it down, but still make it as fresh as everything else on the menu. And so that's our sometimes I see the parents stealing some of the chicken because it's so good. So.
Weekly specials. Do you guys have weekly specials?
We do. So on Mondays, we talked about our meatballs earlier. We have a meatball appetizer that we mark down to $5 with the purchase of a pizza or a pasta or an entree.
Nice.
For a dine-in special. So that's Monday nights from 5 to close. And then Tuesday nights are our half-price pizza nights. So all of our pizzas are half-price from 5 to 6:30 on Tuesday nights for our dine-in customers. And then Wednesday nights, we do a wine-down Wednesday. We're a $5 glass of wine, $20 bottles on select wine. So that's kind of our early week specials. And then Thursday through Saturday, it's just a party around here. We have a good time.
All right. Well, we're here kind of on Wednesday night, kind of like right in the middle of it. Looking forward to, again, getting to enjoy some of this incredible food. And, you know, after the way things changed for really a lot of businesses back in 2020, delivery, curbside, pickup, all those kind of things really became a mainstay for businesses to be successful. What kind of things like that do you guys offer here at Emma L's?
Sure, and that was a large part that influenced the design layout of the restaurant. I knew it was very important to have a dedicated to-go entrance where you don't have to walk through the whole restaurant to pick up your food, but you can just come in the door, grab your to-go to go order and then head home or head wherever you're headed next. So we have just on the north end of our restaurant, we have a dedicated to-go entrance where you can do just that. You can come in, pay, you can order online, and we can even do curbside. If you don't want to come into the restaurant, we can take it out to you and make it real convenient.
Awesome. Yeah. Very and cool. Again, want to order online or check out everything that they have, it's emmaels.com.
That's right.
Is the website. And then also, you guys are all over social media as well, too. I believe it's at emmaels.okc.
That's correct.
So okay.
That's
so, correct. So if not, if you haven't already, hey, get out, visit the website, get on over, give them a like on and a follow on social media. Again, emmaels.com and at emmaels.okc. I can go on the website to maybe it is a Friday night and I want to do a date night or something like that. I can go on the website and make reservations.
Absolutely. You can make reservations online. You can book your large party as needed. We've got our phone number listed there. So if you'd rather call and order, you can do it over the phone as well. And you can also take a look at our extended menu. I know we've talked about a number of items tonight. Something that I haven't touched on yet is that it meant a lot to me to be able to offer gluten-friendly options as part of our Italian fare. And so we have gluten-free pasta, we have gluten-free pizzas that we can do. And so we've had a great response on those items.
Yeah.
And the good news about those too is that we don't charge extra for the gluten-free items. They're included in the regular price.
Yeah, you see that at a lot of places that you go, an upcharge for gluten-free or things like that.
Right.
So you guys, hey, you're going to take care of anybody and everybody that walks through the doors or
Absolutely.
Orders online, wants curbside pickup. So you guys, new sponsors for Bronco Athletics and Bronco Football this year and stuff. Where does that desire for you guys, because you're a brand new business. I mean,
sure.
You're really still kind of trying to get your feet underneath you and get things rolling, and you guys decided to just jump right in. Where does that desire to be, you know, a partner with the local communities come
sure.
from?
Sure. I think it's a great question, and I think it's so important to give back to the community that supports the restaurant. And so I think it can be a mutually beneficial relationship, and so we wanted to link up with Mustang Athletics and be a sponsor as much as we could for the football and basketball and other sports as around the school year, as the school year goes through. And so it's important to us as a restaurant because we realize that we're supported by the community. We want to turn back and support
Absolutely.
The community as much as we can.
I say this every week, but it just holds true, and it's so important to me to say it, that the businesses, the local businesses that support our kids, we need to go out Bronco Nation and support them.
Yeah.
And I can tell you, if you walked in here and just took a sniff, you're going to be proud and excited to do that. I will be back supporting this business. And thank you so much for everything that you've done
Absolutely.
For Mustang Athletics to support us and especially our kids.
Yeah, I'll tell you, during the games, Friday night games at home, I'm up top calling the games, and I've got a great view of our video board, and I've gotten distracted a time or two when I see the MLS commercial come over the video board. I'll be talking, and then somebody beside me will be like, hey, we're live, we're on air, and I'm just sitting there looking like, just so it is outstanding stuff. So anything else you want to tell us, anything at all you want to share about MLS, how you guys got here, just whatever, just
sure,
take some time and tell the story.
It's just been a wonderful ride. We started construction in October of 2021, and that's still where the COVID construction and all of the delays that came in with shipping and all that stuff, getting all the materials to us, was still a challenge. And so I look back on when we started construction to when we opened in August of 2022, just the great response we've had from the community, everyone that's come to see us and dine with us. But there are still people out there that haven't had the chance to dine with us. Yeah. And so I want to welcome everybody who hasn't, or if you have before, welcome you back to come check out MLS and come have a pizza or pasta, whatever your favorite Italian item is, and come see us here at the restaurant. So excited about that.
This place is pretty crowded tonight, and it's, you know, you just seen people in and out the entire time we're here. So if that's any indication of, you know, of how good the food is, it's pretty good sign.
Yeah, for sure. And Coach will say, this guy, since we got here, I got here around a little bit between 5:15, 5:30. He hasn't stopped.
Working.
This is the, I won't say the least busy because he's still working right now. But since we've got, I mean, just here, there, he's in the kitchen, he's helping, he's seating, he's bussing tables, he's doing everything. And they've got a great staff here. We have been inundated with outstanding host coming over. Hey, can I get something else for you? Would you like me to refill your tea? All those kind of things. So we have been treated, and we haven't spent a dime yet, and we've been treated like kings since we walked in. So, yeah, you and your staff, outstanding job.
Thank you very much.
If the small sampling we've had of the bread is any indication of what's to come, top notch. Can't wait.
Well, I appreciate it. Thank you.
Ready to get after it. So again, hey, you're out and about or you just don't want to cook. It's Emma L's Italian Kitchen here at 4401 Grant Boulevard, right on Route 66 off the Kilpatrick Turnpike. Stop by. You can dine in, carry out, curbside, all of that available at emmaells.com. And again, over on social media at emmaells.okc. So, Cameron, thank you so much for having
thank
us tonight. Thanks for your sponsorship
thank you.
Bronco football and Bronco athletics and being a great host here tonight. So,
pretty cool place. Better come check it out.
Yeah.
Thank you,
we
guys.
Will take a timeout, and we will be back and talk about this week's game against the Norman Tigers.
Oki Print Barn is a proud sponsor of Mustang Athletics. For the best in custom apparel, contact Oki Print Barn today. Oki Print Barn, your hometown screen printer located on Highway 152 in Mustang. Let's go Broncos!
Discover authentic Italian cuisine at Emma L's in West OKC, featuring freshly prepared Italian favorites. Everything made to order. Dine in or get it to go. Emma L's Italian Kitchen, Kilpatrick Turnpike and 39th Expressway. Let us do the cooking.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Hey, Coach, great visit with Cameron Wilson, owner here of Emma L's. And hey, the main dishes have been replaced with, I believe we have some Italian cream cake, but problem is they only brought one slice.
Let's go.
Is it fair? No, you. But I'm left-handed.
That's so. Fine. Okay. It doesn't matter.
No. Hey, all joking aside, outstanding host, great place. I will admit, I sampled a little bit of the pizza.
Yep.
That pepperoni pizza, and it tastes even better than it looked.
So. In all seriousness, this is an awesome – this is a super cool place.
Yeah.
I will be frequenting here, I promise
yep.
you.
Yep.
It's food is incredible.
Coach, it's week 8. The Norman Tigers come to town, and I'm going to give you some of the fan stats like I do before. 15th yep. meeting all time against Norman. We're 9-5 overall, and we've won 4 of the last 5. But I know right now in your head you're going, Ryan, that doesn't matter.
Sure.
None of that counts for anything. But
it's great. You know, it's great stats. But it surprised me that Mustang and Norman have not played more than 15 times in the history. That's interesting.
Yeah. But, yeah, you trace it back, and that's what – and, you know, a lot of it, all the different shuffling of districts all the time and things like that. But, again, yeah, so, you know, we've fared well against the Tigers. Norman, 2-5 overall, 2-2 in district. But it's – don't let that record fool you. They're a quality football team.
Absolutely. They've beaten Edmond North, and they've beaten Edmond Memorial. So, this game with us this week is for them, you know, they feel like they're playing for a home field playoff game, which would be a big deal for them. So, you know, a week ago, you know, we look up and when our game's finished and they're beating Edmond Santa Fe by 10 points late in the game and end up getting beat by like 4 or 5 points. Yeah,
52-48.
Yeah, but, I mean, they're right there with Edmond Santa Fe, so definitely a team that, you know, is dangerous. And you know, we're coming in, you know, a little bit banged up. So it's definitely a game that should be an interesting one.
Well, yeah, that was actually my first question. You got to it earlier in the show. The status of Trajan. Trajan's out.
Yep, Trajan's out.
So he's going to be out. So last week, post-game, you told me that you guys were going to have a game plan to showcase Tyson's skill set. I'm assuming that's what's been going on this week.
You never know what you might see out there.
I love it.
But yes, Tyson Pogai will start the game, and we're really honestly excited to see him put in a situation where the game plan reflects what he's best at. So what that is, you shall see
just
a little bit.
But. I was going to say, it's safe to say the quarterback run game probably won't be quite as heavy as it was with Trajan, but who knows?
Who knows?
We'll just leave it at that.
Time will tell, and that time is coming quick.
Yeah.
And I'm not going to say that, you know, you might see 10 different guys back there taking a snap. You never know what's going to happen.
Whatever it takes for sure, and I know the guys will be ready. But, hey, Norman, a number of returning starters on both sides of the ball, so an experienced football team, and really it's their quarterback, number 6, Phoenix Murphy, that obviously kind of makes it go for them.
Very much so. He's a great player, very shifty, does a great job of just, you know, when the pocket breaks down or the original, you know, play called is not open, he does a great job of scrambling, getting off schedule, you know, keeping his eyes down the field and making plays down the field. His receivers really believe that he's going to get them the ball, and they keep working. That's the thing that scares us the most is just, you know, you can make initially a great defensive play. You can cover the route concept that they run. You can get pressure on the quarterback and his ability to extend the play and still find a receiver down the field, you know, by extending it makes, you know, always as a coach, it makes you makes you nervous. So he's a great player. You saw him do that time and time again a week ago versus Edmond Santa Fe. Got several good targets. We saw them in a summer 7-on-7, and they've got some athletic, you know, players that are that are tall and fast and definitely have big play capability. The running back, Devin Alexander, number one is his name. He is you know, got several Division II offers. The research we found on him showed that he has the school record, the Norman school record in the 100-meter dash, and he's a 4.53 laser 40 time, so he can fly.
Got some speed for sure. That explains it. I mean, he's averaging 136 rushing yards a game. So, again, another week where you see a strong running back.
I mean, that's 6A football. You know, everybody's got a good back, and we've got a couple, three or four of them that can rock and roll for us as well. So, we've got to be disciplined. We've got to be able to make the tackle. We've got to take great angles. When you're playing against guys that are shifty, you've got to be disciplined in your tackling. And when you're playing the guy that's fast, you've got to take great angles to get to the tackle. So, should be a good challenge for us this week.
Watching some film on them this week, one thing that kind of caught my eyes, and it's not all the time, but they've got a running back number 9, Dax Knowles. Really good pass catcher out of the backfield.
We feel he's also their Wildcat quarterback and starting safety. Yeah. He's given us fits for 3 years. We feel like that he's one of their absolute best players. And young man, I believe that that he is an Ivy League type of a prospect from what we understand. I'm actually friends with his grandfather. Dax's grandfather was at one point the president of the Oklahoma FCA.
Okay.
And their family's been really involved in that. So excellent player. Has made plays on us since he was a sophomore, and I was really disappointed to learn that he was back for another year. I thought he was a senior last year, and then we saw him in this summer, but he's a great player, definitely one of their best players, a two-way starter, and a guy that we will know where he's at all night long.
One of their leaders on the defensive side of the ball kind of mirrors Mustang, number 44, linebacker. They've got a Bear on their team as well. Bear Boyd leads their team with 58 tackles. And then talking about Knowles, he's actually tied for the team lead as well with 58 tackles. Yeah. But Bear Boyd, they're kind of in the middle.
They do a good job with their scheme of freeing up their linebackers to be able to have open run-throughs just the way that they align their defensive linemen. It's different than what you see, on a normal Friday night. It's very creative. And how they line those guys up without giving too much information, but it creates some run throughs for, you know, they keep linemen off of their linebackers and create some run throughs for those guys to make plays, and they're very capable. Their entire linebacking core, I think their outside backers are excellent players as well. That's a good unit.
Yeah, watching that on film, you do see sometimes their defensive line almost looks like an offensive line trying to create gaps like you would for a running back to get those guys from the second level some room to get in there and cause some chaos.
They're a big blitz team. They'll bring pressure, I'm sure, all night. And, that's going to be a big challenge for our offensive line to pick some of that stuff up.
So looking forward to it again. Hey, it's pink out night. If you couldn't already tell,
had
a little bit of change. So it's pink out night. And, Coach, I didn't want you to feel left out. So I know you probably won't be wearing this on the sidelines. You guys have probably picked out your game day attire as well. But
I will rock this at the next Mustang basketball or volleyball or a pink out night in another sport for sure.
Yeah,
tonight it's pig out night. right, after we finish here. We'll arm wrestle for that piece of cake there, and I'll probably win it because I'm more hungry than you are.
Yeah, I had the pizza. I'm kind of it's
and then
it's
pink out on Friday for sure.
Friday night, our good friends over at Oki Print Barn.
Very nice.
So if you need one of these for pink out night, hey, get by Oki Print Barn, and they will get you hooked up for sure. We appreciate them. But
yes,
wanted to make sure and get you one of those. 7 o'clock kickoff at home. You say it all the time. Hey, our fans can make a difference in the game.
Absolutely. That's huge. Something else we have going on that I'm so excited about on Friday is it's youth football and cheer night. So
okay.
We'll get all of our future Mustang High School Broncos.
Yes.
That they'll be in their little jerseys, and my little boys will be a part of that. And you know, from our 5U flag teams all the way up to our 11U, you know, teams, and that'll be really, really exciting. You know, it got rained out there that bring out the Broncos, so
right.
They're going to all run out of the tunnel behind us.
Very good.
Get recognized. We'll have some honorary youth football captains. It should be a great night, really cute night as well for the little guys to be out there.
So youth football, youth cheer,
yes.
All that's going to be celebrated as well on Pink Out Night. So, but hey, get there early. There's a couple locations around town. I believe you can stop in and get your tickets early over at Mighty Design and Oki Print Barn. I believe they're $8 a piece, cash only at those locations. Avoid the long lines getting in. But you can stop by Mighty Design and Oki Print Barn and pick up your tickets early before that game. And if for some reason you can't make it out, just like always, we will have every moment for you live on MHSBroncosports.tv. Trey Hunter and I on the call once again, so looking forward to that. And, Coach, I think it's safe to say there will not be a Taylor Swift sighting at the Mustang game this Friday night.
I have no idea why Taylor Swift would be at the game, but
because
you
it's
know
the
what?
Broncos.
You never know.
Coach,
oh,
it's the Broncos.
I get it. Good. Okay.
See, I mean, hey, everybody wants to come to Mustang and watch the Broncos. So, but no, that's been something to watch on the NFL. Just you can't turn on a game without hearing about that.
To be honest, I haven't watched it.
You're too busy. You're too busy getting ready for Norman.
Not a Swiftie.
Oh. We may have to work on that, Coach. Now that you got a pink shirt.
There you go.
Yeah. But no. Hey, again, make sure on social media, follow at MLs OKC for some great content of their food and everything, all the different weekly specials that they have going on here at MLs. But also follow at One Bronco Football, at MHS Bronco Sports, and then I'm at MHS Broncos Voice, and that will keep you up to date with all of the news and notes that is Mustang High School Athletics. So, Coach, it's just about time for kickoff again, a big home contest against the Norman Tigers. Looking forward to it, and then once again, we'll get to chat after the game, so looking forward to that as well. Know you are going to have the guys ready and expecting good things out of the Broncos again this Friday night.
So, had a great week of practice. Time to go put it all together right now.
Get after it. So, hey, again, a big thank you to everyone here at MLS 4401 Grant Boulevard, Route 66, right off the Kilpatrick Turnpike. Check them out online at MLS.com for reservations and online ordering as well. So, Coach, we'll go ahead and put this one to bed, and I think we're going to tackle this Italian cream cake right here. But
nice
not
stuff.
Before
I
we get
that.
Out of here, like we always do,
go Broncos.
Broncos.
Yeah. Numero uno, me and Jersey, like the Super Bowl, man. Then it big as the... Biggest the what? Biggest the what? Biggest the what? Big as the Super Bowl, but the difference is it's just two guys playing that they did in the studio. Usually send they verses back to me and they be terrible just like a 2-year-old. I love a dinner with some fine women when they start debating about who the GOAT. I'm like, go ahead, say it then. Who the GOAT? Who the GOAT? Who the GOAT? Who the GOAT? Who you really rooting for? Like a kid that had bad from January to November. It's just you and Cole.